continued this past week, a big-time main event, a street fight between the World Heavyweight Champion Batista from SmackDown and Raw's Edge.
Take a look.
Time for the main events. Paul London and Brian Kendrick teaming up. And I love this tag team.
Following tag team contest is given for one ball in the ring at a combined weight of 356 pounds. Paul London and Brian Kendrick.
Kendrick and London have teamed before in the past here in the WWE before Brian Kendrick left for international borders. Now Kendrick back in the WWE, once again teaming up with his best friend, Paul London.
Oh, and boy, will they have their work cut out.
And from England at a combined weight of 504 pounds, Burchill and William Regal.
Josh, earlier in the show, we talked about how the tag team division in SmackDown is simply off the charts, and these two, devastating, and Burchill, he's like a human torture device. We've got Regal, who's completely ruthless.
I know Paul Burchill and William Regal would love to get an opportunity at the WWE tag team titles, and we'll see if Regal and Burchill can outdo the cruiserweight duo of Paul London and Brian Kendrick.
Well, London and Brian Kendrick certainly are ones that want to be noticed in this division. They're high-flying, they're quick, they've got great speed. They're going to have to use that to counter the ruthless antics of one William Regal and Paul Burchill.
Obviously, the size and strength advantage goes to Regal and Burchill, as does the nastiness factor. But the speed obviously goes to Paul London and Brian Kendrick.
Okay, speaking of the nastiest factor, Edge Batista street fight this past week on SmackDown really didn't happen.
It was all
a big setup by one Eric Bischoff, who right now has got the SmackDown superstar's attention.
It was all a ruse. It was all a ruse by Eric Bischoff.
Oh, cover here on Brian Kendrick on William Regal.
The Raw superstars leaving Batista all alone in the middle of the ring, and out comes the Big Show and Kane. And now Raw basically trying to rip the heart out of SmackDown, taking out the World Heavyweight Champion.
Cover by Kendrick here, just to count to one before Regal can reach up and bring down Brian Kendrick.
And you know, Batista was left all alone. His good friend Eddie Guerrero received a concussion earlier in the night due to a chair shot from Mr. Kennedy, and that's why Eddie Guerrero couldn't come down to the ring to help out his friend Batista.
Several of the other SmackDown superstars were chasing after the limo of Eric Bischoff, and it left Batista alone and vulnerable, and the Raw superstars certainly took advantage.
I mean, Chris Masters put our general manager Theodore Long in the master lock. That's, SmackDown superstars came up and saw Matt Hardy, Lashley, and JBL, and then that was it. I mean, it was all a setup, like you said, Steve Merrill, by Raw on SmackDown. And I can't wait to see what the repercussions will be on both Raw and SmackDown as we get closer and closer to Survivor Series.
Oh, a wicked kick by Paul London. So to Burchill here in London right now, showing a hint of nastiness and showing that he and Kendrick will not take some of these antics sitting down. Oh! Look at Kendrick and London teaming up.
Ryan Kendrick built up some steam.
And then a sliding knee to the face of Burchill.
Quick tag. Kendrick and London working very well together. Quick tags keeping the other man fresh.
There's that high flying quick speed by Kendrick and London.
Those are Japanese arm drags in stereo by London and Kendrick.
William Regal coming in and getting one full bite. And Kendrick, the back body drop, tremendous. Kendrick flings London into Burchill, and then London there for the step ladder for Brian Kendrick, who flies off and creams Burchill with that elbow.
Brian Kendrick and Paul London all day tough.
The count here on Burchill, able to kick out. Paul London almost had the match won right there.
Hey, come on! Come on!
Paul London off the under the ropes. William Regal pulls the ropes down, and London goes flying, and now Regal, with the referee's back turned, doing what he can to London to damage London. London rolled back into the ring.
This is William Regal and Paul Burchill's MO in this matchup.
Burchill with the cover on Paul London. You know, the small of the back. Sorry,
you know,
Josh.
That's okay. You know, the Regal and Burchill would love to just slow this match down to a grinding halt. Keep Paul London and Brian Kendrick on their backs. That's exactly what Regal and Burchill have done thus far in the latest moments of this matchup.
Well, the one thing they got to do, too, is to keep Paul London and or Brian Kendrick on their side in their corner. They've allowed the two high flyers to tag a lot. That's what they're doing now. Regal. The tag to Burchill. Both working off Paul London in the corner. Burchill takes over.
Under William Regal telling the referee he's sorry. As Paul Burchill, the big Samoan drop.
Right on the ribs. The back of Burchill's head on the ribs of Paul London. And then that can't feel good either. London got his back. Kendrick comes in for the save.
Moonsault pressed by Paul Burchill. That's impressive to see a man of Burchill's size pop off that moonsault.
Oh, the figure four leg lock on Paul London, and Regal comes in and hammers away in the back of London's legs. Uh-oh. Look at the strength of William Regal. Tossing Paul London aside like a rag doll. The cover to two.
That was a butterfly suplex or a double underhook suplex there by Regal on Paul London.
And with the referee's back turned, Regal working on the face and the nose of Paul London. And setting up London for Burchill, who kicks London in the back. Perhaps working on those kidneys, and that's got hurt. London, the back of London now has got to be getting stiff because he's had it worked on quite a bit.
Well, the longer this match goes, the more in favor Paul Burchill and William Regal are, due to the fact that London and Kendrick may run out of gas with their speed, and that's what we're seeing right now. Burchill and William Regal have just completely changed the pace of this matchup.
You see Burchill in a torture device-like grip that he has on Paul London. Working on the back kidney area, you're bruising those kidneys, and it really makes it tough to move. Paul London doing a great job of it right now. London with the counter, and smartly takes Burchill over in this corner of the tag. And a much needed tag. Kendrick out of the top ropes, and the kick, followed up by a drop kick to William Regal, then another to Burchill.
Well, Brian Kendrick's got all of his energy right now, taking out both William Regal and Paul Burchill.
Perfect timing for London to get that tag. Sorely needed it. And look how fresh Kendrick is. Oh, the DDT on Paul Burchill. Perfectly timed. And then the double dropkick by Kendrick and Paul London. Oh, Paul London, the back of the head to Burchill. And that'll do it. Anytime you get kicked in the back of the head, can take you out. And that's what London and Kendrick do.
Bit of an upset. Paul London and Brian Kendrick control mayhem and calculated chaos. Pick up the victory over William Regal and Paul Burchill.
Just when you thought Regal and Burchill had the upper hand, the smaller team of London and Kendrick get it done. He's Josh Matthews. I'm Steve Romero. We will talk to you next week.
Yes, sir, we promised you a great main event here tonight.
Andre, the China
WrestleMania!
Hulkamania is running wild!
My God, what a
match! He missed the match!